another audience, a show we taped earlier today, she was in a wheelchair.
Yeah, my sister was in an earlier tape.
Why is she in a wheelchair?
She was coming home from work one day. It was 11 o'clock at night. She was walking home, and it was a drive by. She got shot in the shoulder, and now she's paralyzed from the chest down. And the boy that shot her heard it on the news, and he turned himself in.
He turned himself
3 days later.
What do you want to say to our guest today? Our guest?
I just want to say y'all should get out while y'all can.
Thank you. You want to
Jennifer, because she's gonna have a baby, I think, and I don't understand how she could sit there and say that her gang or whatever should be with them until the end or whatever. But you know, shouldn't her kid come first? Because I have kids and I wasn't a gang before, and I got out and I take care of my kids now. Because
you're here because your daughter's in the gang.
No, that's my sister.
I'm sorry, your sister. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Your sister's in the gang. Before we talk to you both, we have one other story to introduce. This is Rachel, correct? Rachel, you're 17 years old, and I think we have some videotape of what Rachel has to say about being in a gang.
There was like six guys, and they were like, oh, you know, disrespecting us that I was from, saying, oh, we should smoke you right now. You're nothing but a hater. And I was like, you know, if you need to smoke me, then that's your problem. I'm not going to beg, get on my knees and beg for my life. I've seen people get shot, you know. I can't really say tomorrow I'm going to stop, or, you know, it's just when I stop. But if I don't make it till that day I decide to stop, then that's just the way it happens.
Okay, so Rachel, you're 17 years old. There are, 300 members in your gang, right?
Well, there's probably over that, but, you know, there is a lot.
What's in it for you? Why are you in?
Just basically, when I first moved out to Las Vegas, that's who I started hanging out with, and that's still who I hang out with.
Is your boyfriend in the gang?
I don't have, you know, the boyfriend I have now isn't in, but my baby's dad is in a rival gang.
Your baby's dad's in a rival gang. Where's your boyfriend?
He's at home right now.
At home or in jail?
He's at home. My baby's dad is in jail.
What's he in jail for?
Attempted murder and drug charges.
Okay. What do you do? Do you carry a weapon?
When I need to, I do. But since I've had my baby, I don't have a gun at home or nothing, because to him, you know, a gun could be a toy and he could just pick it up and do whatever with it, so I don't have one at home.
How old is your baby?
He's 2 years old.
A two-year-old son?
Yeah.
Is he talking?
Yeah.
Is he doing any, using any kind of slang or gang symbols or anything?
He don't throw gang symbols, but, you know, sometimes he'll say, what's up, cuz, or what's up, black, or something like that. But, you know, he really doesn't, I don't really like to take him around that situation.
But if you're raising him, he is going to be raised around gangs.
Eventually, I plan to get out, because gang life is not, you know, that's not how I want to spend the rest of my life.
No.
What do you want to say? This is your mom, Brenda. What do you want to say, Brenda?
I just wanted to tell her, my own daughter, plus all the other girls up here, they think they're in these gangs because Mary, I think her name is, so she wouldn't look like a punk. Lisa, so she looks like she fits in. The other one down here, you know, they all say they're in these gangs so they don't look like punks. To me, they are punks. I mean, anybody...
the colors, but I would, you know, die for my homies or my family, you know, because to me, they are my family. When I need someone to talk to, they're there for me. I'm not going to go out and kill innocent people, you know, for nothing, but, you know, if somebody's disrespecting me.
What do you want to say?
Do you think your homies would die for you?
I'm not saying what I do. If they've been in that situation.
No, they wasn't. Yeah, go ahead, Mom. Yeah.
Jenny, when my son got shot, you know, the first thing I asked him, where were your homies? They left him.
We're going to take a quick break. We'll come back and hear what this teen has to say about being in a gang also.
We're just like walk the streets, you know, and look for whoever to go beat up.